And now we will learn how to fix matching mistakes in QuickBooks Online bank feeds. There are two common problems associated with QuickBooks Online matching transactions. The first common mistake is that people click Add and therefore agree with the auto match suggestion when in fact they should have changed what was there. The second common problem is that you cannot match because the bank or the bookkeeper recorded the wrong money amount. Let's address the first problem. What if you match the wrong one? Well, the transaction is already in QuickBooks, so matching the wrong one won't affect your financial records. The only thing that happened is that the transaction wrongfully came off of the review list. You have to send it back to the review list so you can match it to the correct one. Well, there are two ways to send it back to the review list. You can just click Undo, which I'm about to show you, or you can open the transaction and click Unmatch. So, let's go back to QuickBooks Online. Here's the review list where the transactions that we just matched are no longer there. They're in QuickBooks. And when we click in QuickBooks, we get the two transactions that we just matched from the previous video. Now, one way to undo the match so that you could send it back to the review list and match it to the correct one is simply click in QuickBooks, come to the right, and click Undo. Now, that July 31 for $30 is removed from QuickBooks, and it's back in the review list. If I click for review, here it is, $30, July 31, and it again suggests the same match. Okay, what's the other option I spoke about a moment ago? Open the transaction and click unmatch. That'll move it back to the review list while keeping the original transaction in QuickBooks, and then you can match it to the right one. So, if we go back to in QuickBooks, there's only one left in QuickBooks because we removed the other one. Now you could click Undo, but you can only click Undo if you're finding the transaction here in the Bank Feed Center. What if you find the transaction in a report and you open it up and it looks like this, and you know that it should not be matched? You need to send it back to the review list without affecting the actual transaction that was recorded. So your other option is to go right here to the top left and click Online Banking Matches. This choice will be available if this is a matched transaction. And it gives you the details, and all you have to do is click Unmatch. Once you click Unmatch, you can go back to the review list and you can see it is no longer in QuickBooks. If you click for review, you can go down to June 12th and see that this suggested match has now been returned to the review list. Now let's address the second type of mistake that could happen when matching transactions in QuickBooks Online bank feeds. What if you cannot match because the bank or the bookkeeper recorded the wrong money amount? Well, here's what I recommend. I recommend that if it's your mistake, I suggest you edit the transaction before matching it or excluding it. Edit the normal way that you learned in previous videos. If it's the bank's mistake, show the bank the check or the deposit slip and have them fix it, then exclude it from the review list because the result of matching is the same as excluding. It makes sure that you don't double count a transaction. What I do not recommend is that you click the button at the bottom that says Resolve Differences. In my opinion, that is a very bad feature and will only cause problems. This will create a new transaction for the difference in money amounts. That will make your records inaccurate, and it will make the bank reconciliation that you do at the end of the month more difficult. So let's take a look at how we would do it, even though I recommend against it. So let's imagine this $100 is matched to the wrong one with the auto match suggestion. You can click on it, and when you open it up, it will give you a list of every other possible match that you could match it to. So you could match it to the other June 12th, which is what it's suggesting, or you could match it to the other $100 transaction on May 25th. But if you open this blue bar, the only suggestions you get are the ones with the exact money amount. If you want to see suggestions with different money amounts, you have to click this button, Find Other Matching Transactions. And then you'll notice the ones with the same money amount plus some other possible matches would show up here. Now, just to show you how terrible this is, let's imagine we're going to match this $100 transaction that was recorded in QuickBooks with the $30 transaction that was downloaded from the bank. So if I want to match something with a different money amount, I click this one that I'm going to match this one, and it says there's a difference. Now again, I don't recommend you do this, but if you click Resolve Difference, what's going to happen is QuickBooks is going to add a new transaction, and the new transaction will be the difference in money amount. So in this case, it's going to add a $70 transaction just to adjust for the difference. Your books and records are now a total mess. Don't do it this way, even though that feature is included. If you notice the money amount is different, click on it and edit it and make it the correct money amount.